What do you see that TADA is doing differently than other technologies? And what are the implications?
So start with this kind of a business problem, right? So for example, we want to have a comprehensive view of the supply chain, and I can kind of traverse through that data. I can look back in time. I can go forward and project what it may look like. And as you think about that, there's a comprehensive view, but you are also adding this idea of element of a time series to it as an example, right? Or I can just go into a particular asset and kind of look at it almost in the asset in entirety, all the data about it. And then part of that could be I can forecast and simulate not only the financial, but other aspects of that particular asset basis. So to create that view, to solve that problem that we're all trying to solve. What I liked was the way you approached it, which was to say, okay, this is the problem. For this problem, I need these elements in this relationship and with this kind of cause and effect derivation, if you will, between those data elements. And so based on that, you have built really what I call as an intelligent semantic layer, which allows you to define the data elements, define the interrelationships, the linkages. And what is different is it's not the traditional way where you're saying there's one data set, another data set, you do the mapping, and it's kind of that. It really, you're able to traverse through the entire semantic layer as you kind of draw that map, and you can go from one node in the link to another, and so on and so forth. So it allows us to represent the business in the context of that data semantic layer, right? And then you say, okay, based on that, now, don't worry, I will go get the data from wherever the data is and map it to this semantic and then present it in context of that view that we're building. The second thing is that view, the semantic layer, is something that anyone can build, anyone can collaborate. Yeah. And I think that insulates this reality that we have, that data is always going to be fragmented, data is always going to be in multiple places, but it also solves the other problem, which is you don't have to have a different places to have this translation or the vocabulary of data. Here's this one place where you can build this vocabulary that everyone can contribute and reuse it in any context.
No, I think to maybe build on what you said, our understanding, we kind of started at a different place. We realized that you take a large company, you know, some of our customers, it could have been a Ford or a General Electric or somebody. Their company had a culture, and the culture was infused in the words and the vocabulary that they used. So we started the whole hypothesis around the semantic model that you talk about. The semantic model is much deeper than just an ontology or a knowledge graph. We actually used words to describe the operations of a business and the business model and all the flows in the business. And the data was merely used to now represent and create duplicates or digital twins, as we call it, of physical items and the flows between them. So that was, as you call it, you know, a lot more durable, right, and could scale with the enterprise. And we could enrich that with financial data, operational data, you know, people in it. So that was the original experiment, which allowed us to be more than just a data store, and that's what we are finding out today. That's why a lot of companies are, you know, we're running, you know, $30 billion of assets in TADA.